You like my songs? That's actually one of my songs. I wrote the song. And that's me singing on it. It's pretty good, right? Yeah, that's the name of the song is There She Goes, and we recorded it in MIDI on a MIDI piano, and we got so experimental with it that we actually that we simulated a human voice with MIDI. Actually, this is the real song. I'll play a minute of it just to get your appetite whet. It's funny because I don't sing like that on any other song on this album or any in the past. That's literally like a one-off style of singing for me, which is really weird. Like it still sounds like the way I sing a little bit, but I don't know. I think I like the MIDI version better. But now that you've heard the real version, you will hear my singing in this diarrhea mess of piano MIDI. The human brain is a very, very fucking weird thing. Speaking of weird, I don't think I got many years left. I'm gonna get real weird with them. So we're not doing corruptions this week. Next week I'm gonna do some corruptions because I've got a backlog of corruptions and I have some ideas for some corruption runs. However, I have a few weird games again, and just as always, I kind of like to explain that people send me some weird shit, and I don't do most of them, and even the requests I get, like I only do maybe like 20% of what I get, and some of the things that I get I feel would be really funny. Some of it I know will be really bad that I can make fun of. And other things are just, you know, for you guys. They're just for fun, just to have some fucking dopey, stupid fun. And then other things, like tonight, are just really bizarre, like just games I can't really classify anywhere else. And that's this one. I Contemplated the Son of Limbo. That is the name of this game. And I only ever really take a quick look at these games. And I don't really know what the fuck I'm in for most of the time. So this is apparently a Ludum Dare game. So, yeah, I pretty much go into most of these blind. What the fuck? Oh, Critical played this. I actually did not watch his playthrough of this. But this will be good, because then we can discuss this. A stool? What? So, there's just a stool. Okay, you can sit in the stool. I'm not sure what the objective is. I seem to be on some kind of ice cream vomit planet. I'm in a nebular, which is a mix of a nebula and a quasar. I just made that up now. I'm very pleased with myself. Oh, things get weird. Every time you go over the edge of the world, something new and weird happens. This is like Mario Galaxy from someone who's definitely freebased way too much caffeine. Whoa. Okay. Is there some kind of meaning to this, or is this someone figuring out how to use Unity and was like, hey, I'll just do something really weird? Like, I wonder if there's a deeper meaning. There's gotta be deeper meaning to things. I'm on Ice Cream Planet again. Also, just to talk, just for a minute, and to piss that one guy off, I'm gonna talk for a second about the Rick and Morty episode. If you haven't seen it, don't spoil it for people, but pretty crazy episode, huh? I had seen it already. It's sad and weird that a show, a comedy cartoon show, could make you feel in that way over its characters. But a good episode. Really, really good episode. I am excited to see what's next for this show. That's all I want to say. Dude. So, I'm not sure if there are any other buttons. It's season 2, episode 3, for whoever was curious there. Some guy in chat has been asking me over and over again, what kind of nipple are you? What is that question? Like, what is that question? Oh. Slender shape. I didn't expect that. I definitely didn't expect a jump scare. And there's a grave. Like I said, how do you classify this? When I say getting weird with it as my title of this stream, you know, I mean it. Like, what is this? I guess I'm dead. Oh, thank you, Striped Goon. Yeah, KY and I did another Two on the Vine podcast. And, oh. Red Slendies. So if you want to hear a podcast I did with KY, just go to YouTube and type Two on the Vine. We did episode 10. What is this world? Yeah, this won't give anyone a seizure. Definitely not. I contemplated the son of Limbo. We got a name drop, guys. We got a title drop. Just look away if you have epilepsy. That's really all I can say. I'm not sure what the fuck I'm looking at. It's a bunch of grilled cheese men exploded, and now the world is turning into static. and we have a title, which I would imagine is the end of the game. But I don't know. I can't tell. I can't tell because it looks like a Tame Impala album cover. Why won't you make up your mind? Give me a song. All right, well, let's go ahead and stop that now. That was interesting. Slightly, and then it got weird, but it was, you know, weird is good, just not when seizures are happening. One second. This one is called Omnibus, and this is kind of like a beta demo. And this isn't so much weird as it is kind of more funny, but we'll find out. Again, I haven't played it. This is my first time booting it up. We're gonna do story mode. Lower the volume. Why won't you make up my mind? Firework tech. Omnibus. I got a big firework. Look at the firework tech. It's like an old lady from the 40s. Drive off the ramp ahead to help it up. Avoid the bumpers. Why does my bus have a rocket strapped to it? I did not avoid the bumpers. Mistakes were made. I've made a huge mistake. By the way, that's one of my favorite running jokes in Arrested Development. Anytime any character looks at the camera, or somewhat near the camera, and says, I've made a huge mistake. Okay, so this is a game where you play as a shit. This is like Crazy Bus, but playable. Apparently I am a bus with a rocket strapped to it. That's the story, guys. I hope you enjoyed the story of the game. That's all we got. And, oh, man. This is a bit like Monkey Ball meets a pinball, kind of. Monkey Ball meets pinball meets balls meets bus meets roundabout in some ways. No, not really. Okay, I'm in. This is the first level. This is a little much for the first level. Love the music. Oh god. Oh no. Oh no. God damn it. So yes, this game is still in development, so I can't really say anything too bad about it, because there's a lot more work that's gonna go into it. But so far, it is pretty goddamn amazing. And I finally beat a level. USA, USA, what a display. Thanks, Omnibus. The driver and the bus were both destroyed. Thank you, Commissar Krieg. Pilot guy. Now, to learn the most important maneuver, falling through every floor of a building. Make sure your tires aren't towards the ground and make your way to the bottom. Are you serious? I have to crash through a building as a bus. Mission complete! Omnibus, you're the greatest hero that humanity could ever ask for. Rooftop road rage, beeper hater. You could just Google Omnibus. I think you'll find it. Football Joe. The city redirected traffic to my rooftop football field. Now these drivers have road rage. Omnibus, be safe and avoid crashing. Survive for 60 seconds. Okay, Omnibus is now doubled in size. Still going. Kind of. Holy shit, what is going on? Still going. Still alive. Still alive. Oh my god, that's a lot of cars. This is the fucking BQE leading to Manhattan. At like 4 p.m. New York, this is the real New York bus simulator. Just gotta survive for another 1 second. Mission complete, guys. I did it, that was a slam dunk. Good job, Omnibus. Omnibus, take these folks on a tour of the four nicest spots on the island. Just make sure one of them makes it through the whole tour. They'll be looking at anything they want to see close up. Oh, this is amazing. They died! Guys, they're Jens! I'm taking Jens on a tour of the city. Only two Jens remain. Okay. Alright, turning the bus is nearly impossible. There's no brakes on the Omni train, guy. Oh, fuck. Like, I can't fucking slow down. There is no brake button. Oh, shit. All the Jens are dying. Ah, god damn it. There is no gas button. You just move. I'm not actually pressing any buttons except I'm just, you know, moving. Oh no, oh no, oh no, oh no. Oh, Yoko Ono. Yoko Ono. Okay, alright. You gotta go through the beams of light. And you gotta be very careful when turning. Oh my god. Straight through buildings. The music in this game fits perfectly. Mission complete. And now everyone's dead. Now everyone's in the ocean. What a great tour. Great work. Break the bank and become a millionaire. The Mafia. Hey, Omnibus, I need you to break into the central bank and collect $1 million from my goons and I, see? You'll need to be going real fast, see? I'll toss you a cut if you do it good, see? God. Sweet God in the heavens. Where is this bank? Oh, there it is. All right, so I really need to plot this out a little bit better. Oh, 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 oh! Oh, oh! right. There's a good, easy way to do this, I think. And it involves this. And not that. Almost, almost. You actually have control over your bus when it's in midair. Not much, but you can kind of control like where the wheels go. Shit. I keep missing. Keep missing that. Just gotta turn a little bit more to the left, I'll probably get it. Oh, god damn it. God damn it! It's like on a slight incline, so it's really hard to like maintain speed up the incline. Got it. There you go. Oh, now I gotta collect the money. It's not over yet. Why does it say restart or quit? Oh, no, 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 no! Save me, green car! Green car did not want to save me. God damn it. Yes! I cheaped it out, guys. Alright, now, if I could just make a successful landing- Oh, fuck. We're going bumper to bumper. God damn it. Hey, while I'm doing this, I'll tell you guys a funny story. Today, I was playing Counter-Strike for a little bit, and it was just, you know, regular old match, and just a bunch of, like, you know, and the voice chat was not happening that often, but when it happened, it was a few guys just making fun of each other, and then a girl meowed, and it was an actual girl whose profile said, "Yes, I'm a girl, get over it," and then suddenly guys started talking. One guy was a streamer. He said, "I just hit 50 subs, guys. This is amazing." He's like, "I'm gonna do a random, like, giveaway. Guess who won?" And it was the girl's name. Randomly, the girl won the random giveaway. Randomly, totally randomly, to get the gun skin in CSGO. And there was another guy who was like, "Oh man, I had so much coffee today. Like, I had so much. I haven't slept in 48 hours. Like, 48 hours I haven't slept. I know, that's crazy." And then, you know, the girl was like, you know, nice. She was playing along. She was being nice to people, and they were all giving her a lot of attention. And she was like, "You know, people were bullying me, blah, blah, blah." They're like, "Don't let people get you down. You're amazing. Also, could you add me on Steam? Because that would be awesome. You seem really nice." And it was like the whole game was then about her and not Counter-Strike. And I said in the chat, I'm a grill. Can I get a skin? Does anyone have a free skin for me that I could win randomly?" And people were like, what do you make?" I said, "Hamburgers and hot dogs. That's the kind of grill I am." So it was a good time. Good match of CSGO. Very enjoyable. Shit, no. Ugh, god damn it, this is hard. This is a hard mission. For the record, I don't think she added anyone back on Steam. But like, there was a few people that had a mumble, and they're like, "Teamspeak, I'm sorry." And they were like, "Hey, can you join my Teamspeak, bro?" And she was like, "I don't know." They're like, "No, join our Teamspeak. It'll be great." Whenever like one of the dudes that was like fawning over her like killed her, they would say, "I'm sorry." It was I hate to use the word cringy, but you know, I'll use that word because it's 100% appropriate. So that's what happens if you claim to be a girl in Counter-Strike and subsequently are a girl on the microphone, or you're just, you know, an 11-year-old boy, in which case your voice, if you play it the right way, you can get some free skins, bro. So that's something that happened today that I guess I've seen at other points in my life, but I just forgot that kind of thing existed. It still happens. But I mean, you know, if you're a girl and you're playing the computer games and you write, "Yes, I'm a girl," in your profile, and you're like meowing so that people like know you're a girl. I wonder if that's the attention that you're kind of after. Or like, "Don't hit on me, silly boys," that kind of thing, you know? Or if the guys, and this is a question I'm posing, or are the guys just completely thirsty for that? You know? Tough to say, really. And it's a shame, you know, it's a shame that a girl can't play Counter-Strike and just go on the microphone and start talking without like 7 really lonely like 15-year-old dudes like offering her to, you know, buy her skins and stuff. Wait a minute, that doesn't sound like a bad deal actually. Anyone want to do a Ponzi scheme? Anyone? Well, she did randomly get a free skin, so that was pretty good. I guess it could have gone a lot worse, and no one was harassing her by any means. I'd say people were actually being extra nice. It disrupted the flow of the game entirely, but eh, whatever. It seemed like she enjoyed it. So, you have to ask yourself the question, is it a bad thing? I was cringing for a full half hour, but, you know, I guess they enjoyed themselves. Also, this mission sucks. I hate this mission. Someone in chat says just playing a female character gets you tons of unwanted attention in video games. So, you know what? That's true, though, because I knew someone in World of Warcraft 10 years ago that played a female character, and he just got free shit constantly. And never spoke, like, on microphone. It was just, you know, someone who was just taking advantage of the system. But then again, he was scheming. You know, he was the type of dude that was like, "Hey, I'm a girl. Check this out." And then people would, like, flock to him and give him free shit. So, insane. Yeah, it's pretty crazy. I think you gotta, that's the other thing too, yeah, you gotta flaunt it. You gotta be like, "Hey, silly boys," that kind of thing. If you're just playing as a girl character, that's not good enough. You gotta really let it know, like, you gotta let everyone on the server know. That's how you do it. Because then, it inevitably, at least 10%. will want to get your attention, and that's how you get your free shit. Congratulations, dude. I think I'm done with this game. You know what? I'll try one more time, guys. Alright. Bank is open. The music is awesome. So I'm just happy to keep going with this music. But the mission sucks. Look at this. If you keep yourself kind of exactly level, you're good. But you know what the problem is? It's that where all the money is, it's elevated. What was that? What kind of physics were those? One more time. This is it. Last time. And the other problem too, just to close out this topic, people are saying harassment. Yeah, well, of course that's a problem because people are fucking stupid and people are assholes. There's always going to be harassment. So, sometimes you'll get free shit, sometimes you'll get attention, and sometimes you'll get unwanted attention. You know, there's no denying that. So there's definitely at drawbacks as well. Just wanted to point that out. I was not oblivious to that fact by any means. Anyway, just to finish this up, this will be my last attempt at this. I need to get 1,000,000 shekels. 1,000,000. I'm halfway there almost. The speed boosts are not helping. The speed boosts are very, very opposite of helping. Alright, there should be... There should really be a way to flip your bus over if you land on the side. Upside down? Yeah, that sucks. But on the side? It's like that happens way too much.
Yesterday, you said tomorrow. So just do it! Make your dreams come...
I just watched a clip of Shia LaBeouf talking about how he got arrested at Cabaret. And... I applaud the guy's honesty, but what a strange guy Shia LaBeouf has turned out to be. What a strange, strange guy. And Spielberg was treating him like the next Harrison Ford. Just, you never know. All right, listen, that was Omnibus. It was cool. I liked it. Looking forward to see more from that game in the future. Hopefully they work on it. Hopefully there's more missions. Hopefully there's more variety. Really cool game, though. And I think it has potential, for sure. So, don't let your dreams be dreams. God damn it, Shia. All right. This next game is called The Static Speaks My Name. I don't know what this is at all, in fact. I don't even remember seeing what this looked like. I just remembered that I was interested, and I said to myself, yeah, I'm going to play this. So, here it is. Whatever this is. Mouse to look around, right-click to zoom, E to interact. Space. And it crashed. Good start. Try it again. Okay, so I'm in space. I'm falling in space. Some kind of gravity well in space. I know. It's weird. Name, Jacob M. Holtz. I can't read a lot of this text. Age 31, asphyxiation by hanging. What? It's a depressing game, Vinny. Today will be a better day. Oh, God. Oh, God. Is it one of these games? I think I'm gonna have to balance out how depressing this is with some music. I don't even know if I want to take the plunge and start playing this, because people are saying it's really, really depressing, and it's like, yeah, I'm not streaming to get people fucking miserable, because, you know, you can play it yourself if you want to do that. You know, a noose. I'll give it a chance. All right, is this a guy sitting down to piss? Clear piss. Best piss. Still empty. I guess it's shrimp again. Wait, so you mean my pet shrimps? Am I eating live shrimp? What the fuck is this shit? Vinny, this is a game about suicide. Oh! Well, whoever sent this to me, I don't know if you mentioned if, you know, it was a game about suicide, but there's a good chance I wouldn't have played it if you had told me that. What's that saying? Yeah, I don't think I want to start getting people depressed, so how about this? Let's just end it with me eating my shrimps. Let's leave it at that. You guys can check it. It's called The Static Speaks My Name. If you're in the mood for a really bad time, if you're in the mood for a suicide and depression simulator, and I know there's a demand for that, otherwise they wouldn't make them, then yeah, go ahead and play it. But I'm going to pass. What was that, Shreya? Don't say it. Don't you dare. Don't you dare.
Do it.
No. Anyway, next is... What the hell is this? Hang on. Checking this out. Making sure I haven't streamed this already. Alright, well, I don't think I've streamed this. This looks brand new. or at least brand new to me. This is called Starfish. Not to be confused with chocolate starfish in the hot dog flavored water. So the music has a Doppler effect, which makes no sense. Even more so, my character. I don't think the legs of my character quite work. It's quality streaming, guys. This is quality streaming. Nice characters, nice modeling. Really nice. This is probably worse than the Fantastic game in some ways. Is this real or did I get sick from eating those shrimp pets? I swear to God, guys, it's almost impossible to walk in this game. And you get stuck on the ground. My character's legs get stuck on the ground, and the camera... The camera is, like, kind of permanently skewed to the right a bit. So whenever you try to walk straight, you walk to the right, ever so slightly. This is terrible. I don't think I've ever experienced a game where your character gets stuck walking on solid flat ground. Let's look at this masterwork of 3D modeling, shall we? It looks like Sausage Baby Dog. My name is Sausage Baby Dog. What's your name? What's that? Dildo Beans? Oh, hi Dildo Beans. Would you like to be friends with me, Sausage Baby Dog? Now that feels pretty good. Okay, so yeah, this was included in a pack of games. So, I just kind of, when I got them, I just kind of did a quick look. And I said, sure, okay, I did not get to this game. So this is new to me. And I am appalled at how I have not played this yet. I've had this sitting here for weeks, and I hadn't played it. It is so good. Look, oh, I kicked a jelly, a jelly dildo. What is that? That's like one of my legs, just shorter. Gotta say, the grass is really well done. How is that possible? Look at that. Moves? It's better grass physics than Rust. These sausage baby dogs can't really move. They're like... Actually, they look more like pigs. Alright, let's go to the concert, shall we? So this is the concert. I'm assuming these turrets with balloons on them are actually supposed to be people. And you can see there's some diversity here. There's black and white together, just dancing around. So this is not the Bernie Sanders speech. You got a couple of drummers here. And on the back, they have shirts that say Starfish 2014. Actually, their drumsticks say that too. So they're advertising the game within the game, just in case you didn't know. I don't know what else there is to do. There's no button to interact with anything. I'm pretty sure I've seen everything. Somehow this video is gonna get a fuckload of views on the Full Sauce channel. That's the sad thing. Like, it's always shit like this that does really well on Full Sauce. Metal Gear Solid 3? That'll do alright. This'll break the view counter, guys. Even though they just fixed it, it'll break it again. We're going back to 301 with this shit. You heard me, Morty? I mean, guys? I think that's it. That's the whole game. Or quote-unquote game, I'm sorry. I actually just offended myself by saying the word game. Here, let's just go check out these guys over here real quick. And we'll just... Alright, this guy's wearing a different shirt. Kinda, can I get through here? Almost. Almost! If my sausages weren't preventing me, I could clip through this wall, guys. And get to the secret mountain of Kothorak. Nope. Stuck. Completely stuck. There's a good chunk of my audience that would prefer if I only streamed games like this. And to you, I say no. Look, I found a hidden secret, guys. Soap. It's a texture that says soap. Completely inaccessible. You can't get there. You have to glitch to see it. It's a secret. It's a secret, guys. We did it. We found the secret. Well, that's the whole game. And again, I just called it a game. I regret that highly. Well, that was Starfish, and that's a pinnacle, I think. I think we've reached a new pinnacle. What's the opposite of pinnacle? Is there like a different word? Like, there's pinnacle and then there's like dinnacle. What's the polar opposite of pinnacle? Pit? Endless pit? Perhaps? Valley? Rock bottom. There you go. Rock bottom. Abyss. We've reached it, guys. We did it. Together. Next up is a game called Nazi Zombies Engine. Oh, this one looks fucking bad. This one looks real bad. It's full screen, so, you know, one of these. So, you know. Map 1, lockdown. Lots have died, and even more lost families. You are our last hope. You can save us all. You are superhuman that can heal. So do us proud. God, that's loud. Was there really a need to remake the Call of Duty zombie thing? Like, did we need a remake? I feel like I'm surfing in the ground. Okay, I have one ammos. You died. Lost your cash too. Guys, I died. I don't know if you saw that, but I died and lost my cash too. How do you buy things? How do you buy things? Every button. Nothing works. No buttons work. Escape exits the game, which is the best button. That is officially the best button in the game. There's a single player. Hang on. We gotta load it again. Hang on a sec. I'll lower the volume. Hang on. This is a weird night so far. Are you guys enjoying this? You know, just the weirdness of everything that's happening, because, you know, I love it. I love that it's like a grab bag. You don't know what you're going to get. But I'm also kind of dying a little bit. Get the ammo is the story. Lots have died and even more, so do us proud. All right, so the movement button is W, correct? I'm stuck in the ground. I'm actually stuck and cannot move. You died and lost your cash, too. Abandoned safe house. All right, now I can move. Let's go through furniture. All right, I don't know how much more I can squeeze out of this game, guys. It's really bad, and there's no way I can buy cash. I like how when I just go up to a window, it repairs automatically. Zombies are pretty styling, though. Gotta say, Captain Jack Sparrow zombies. It's a good look. All right, yeah, I can't do any more of that. That's really bad. That's really, really bad. Anyway, I think I have one more weird game for you guys. You know what? What is this? Okay, I have Janus VR again. But I'm not going to do Janus VR this week. Because... it's getting late, and I don't want to... I didn't realize how long I was going. So it's getting late. Janus VR, we got some new locations. I'm going to give it one more week. So next week, I'm going to probably... I'll hold off for until either next week or the week after. And I'll show you guys some cool stuff. The developers of Janus VR are really, really awesome people. And then there's some people from Vinesauce like Norix and Monotonist that have been working... with the developers, and they've compiled a list of weird places for me to check out on stream, and they've also kind of made it easier to navigate the games and the places, and it's just a much better experience now than it was a few weeks ago. And there's a Vinesauce portal right on the main page, on the main hub of Janus VR. So look forward to that soon. I'll show you guys all that stuff. I'm going to play one more really weird game that I don't know what to expect. It's called Amish Brothers. So
Brothers, Ezekiel, and Abraham.
Uh-huh. So with a name like Amish Brothers, you can't go wrong, really. Ah. All right, we went wrong. I'm done. Okay, you know what? Let me try that again. Wanted to see the story. I skipped the story by accident. Okay, graphics are all good. Volume should be good. Amish Brothers. Where's the awesome voice acting? All right, hang on. Something's weird.
Brothers Ezekiel and Abram have left Brother Jebediah alone to run the farm today. Oh no! Last night a huge storm came through and startled the farmyard animals. The animals have escaped from the barn. Help Brother Jebediah gather all the animals before they stray too far away.
There are 4,000 people watching this. Ah! 4,000 people watching this. Think about that.
all sheep return to the barn. All sheep return to the barn.
4,000.
All sheep return to the barn.
The music reminds me of Super Mayrocrat. Just one guy on an acoustic guitar playing into a computer microphone.
All sheep return to the barn.
I wonder if I just stand here, how many sheep I'll get. Well, I think we've seen enough. That is officially how you know I've gone too far. There's probably... There's an image I have for this. That's, I think probably the best way to sum this all up. Anyway, we're going to take a quick break. I'm going to come back with Bayonetta 2. And that's weird. It's exceptionally weird. Just a few minutes. I'm going to just like screw my brain paste back into the head. And you guys stick around for a little bit because Bayonetta 2 is up next, which is a good game. And... you know, I think you'll enjoy it. Thank you, Orokai. Some really weird, bizarre, amazing, terrible games tonight. It was truly a grab bag of shit. I remember I used to go to Lake George when I was younger, and that's in upstate New York, and there was this one store that would sell grab bags, and you'd buy the grab bags for like, you know, $3 each one, and you would open them up and you'd get little toys in them. There'd be like playing cards or like Cracker Jack type toys or like cards. I said cards already, or like Pogs, because there was, you know, Pogs at the time, or little figures or, you know, planes, whatever. There was, you know, stuff in them. But every now and then you would get one that was just garbage. It would be like a little pig. Like a little plastic pig that you could choke on. Like a rusty cunt's baseball card. Like a ripped like page out of a magazine. Like really, really like terrible. So you would get sometimes decent stuff, like a little plane you could build yourself and throw it. Or you would get rusty cunts. So, you know, that was tonight. Tonight was that grab bag. And I think we got a few pigs, few rusty cunts, but we also got some planes. And we also got some weird analogies. So I'll be right back, guys, with Bayonetta 2.